Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, it's really afternoon, soon the lunch. I would like to speak today about humanoids on which I am working. I'm director of research on robotics in NTU and also some activity in Switzerland. And what I'd like to share with you today is more a global view, because we speak of AI, we speak, of course, of robots. But what I like to show you is, when did it start to think about robotics? When do you think? Actually, everybody speaks about, but is it 10 years ago, 20 years ago, 50 years ago? Anyway, I will discuss this. And the other thing, I will show you over time how things have allowed us to come to the point that today we are able to move on robots. And the last part of my intervention today is to discuss with you and show you what is the real case study with humanoid robots we have developed in NTU. So the answer to the question I proposed before was, you see, the first or among the first humanoid robots was at the time of 250 years before Christus. And I think this is absolutely a marvel, because you see, the Greeks were very strong to make fantastic statues, and they have slaves, and they were driven to free the slaves and to use automaton. So in fact, at that time, it has started to think, you know, automaton, that means today robots. So that's fantastic to see that if you go to one museum in Greece, you can see this kind of automaton dressed like a maid. And we can see the video here. You will just see that was quite a lot of knowledge in mechanics, let's say simple mechanics, because it's before Newton's laws. But as you can see here, the interest, they have two recipients. For example, this one, if you were a visitor, you could put your cup, and the automaton was able automatically to pour out wine or water, depending on what you like to have. So you see, what is fantastic in this, in the story of humanity, it has started 250 years before Christus, and people were dreaming of it, of course. Some simple technology was able to do. Now, if we skip the centuries, and I keep a bit the Western knowledge about it, there are quite a lot of similarities in the Asian world, in China and other countries. Of course, everybody knows Leonardo da Vinci, and he too was building robots. You see here with some mechanics, and what is interesting here, you have a robotic knight. And when you have VIP coming, this robotic knight was able to sit down, to bow, and, you know, to do all kinds of automatic actions. So you see, the dream goes on. We are here in the 15th century, and this we have found a lot of drawings of Leonardo, and this is also available in different museums. Now, I skip also in the past, and what are the main discoveries that has improved the robotic? First of all, you know, you have a single mathematician, Boole. You have surely heard of him, you know, in the 19th century, working on his own. And he invented, some people have worked before, but he invented the algebra with zero and one. And then this is the basic for every computer. So if we wouldn't have Boole in the history, we wouldn't progress today with computers. So you see, it's an addition to the know-how. So, and another thing which we discover, and this is AI today, how we make similarity with neural networks, is that in the 40s, they were biologists discovering that our brain is done with electrical network of neurons that fired in all or nothing pulses and signals. And, you know, as we have to express everything in computer science with numbers, Boole's description of zero and one and the way how our own brain functions have similarities. So these two discoveries are very, very important. Okay, so let's move on a bit on a global view of what has happened until now. You see, everybody has seen this kind of diagram, but it's maybe interesting to summarize. So you see, finally, after Newton, because Newton has brought formal laws of physics that allow to simulate quite a lot of things. You know, in robotics, it's very important. So in the 18, at the end of the 18, we see that we have the steam power. So that was a big change and the start of mechanical production and the railroads, which are new. Now, if we go at the second revolution, you see the mass production thanks to electricity also. So the electricity comes out. And what we see already is the assembly line. So we can see automaton doing things, particularly in the weaving industry. Now, if we look in the third revolution, you see that there is an automatic production of electronics. So we are now in 1969 around, and of course, the big thing is with electronics, the computer can be done. So you see, what is interesting in this, that without the past, we would not be today here. And what is important also to think is our former ancestors were dreaming the same as we, and probably the next one will continue the chain. So today, of course, we are in the fourth revolution, and what is new? We speak about AI, we speak about big data, robotics, and of course, more to come. So, in fact, today, what has made possible that suddenly everybody speaks of AI? This morning, I didn't calculate, but surely we have heard 1,000 times the word AI. But 10 years ago, we didn't hear. 20 years ago, we heard already, because there was a vague in the 90s of AI, but it was more theoretical modeled AI. Now, AI is done from data. So what we can see here, why it has changed suddenly these last 5 years mainly, is because we can track through to all kinds of devices like 3D cameras or speech. We can track a lot of data. So this is this interaction that has allowed to make a big boom. And of course, from this data, as everybody has spoken this morning and knows, we can analyze and model events and even predict the future and make a lot of application. Okay, if we come to our robots today, of course, there are quite a lot of robots, and surely the ones you know is maybe not in the list. I cannot make extensive lists, but let's say myself, I'm interested in humanoid robot. We have produced this Nadine social robot. You can see with me reading a newspaper in NTU. And of course, I think the robotics kind of robot came mainly from Japan. And you have also heard from Sophia. You can see at the right who is done by Hanson Robotics. And below, there are not so much humanoid appearance, realistic, but still Atlas from Boston Dynamics is maybe the most capable robots because this robot can lift weights and can also walk on any terrain. The same, you know, Asimo, the same, and Pepper, I think many people have seen this robot. So you see quite a lot of development. It doesn't go as far as we think because we don't see them. If it would be so simple, why are they not around? They are not around. They are still case studies. And it's almost enough to show you in one page. So it's still a lot to be done. Let's go to Nadine, the one we have developed in NTU. You see her real robotic aspect is the left image, like every robot. And of course, we have worked on face and you know, skin and so on, and it's how she appears. So you see one of the main applications, we know that the elderly are growing in high number. I read yesterday, I think that Singapore still have one child per family natality. So what do we do with the elderly? The poor children or young will have to I don't know how to do. So we need absolutely robots to be there when nobody is there. So you see, the social robotics are the robots that can care for others. So how does it work? I just would like to share with you our research and development. Here you see we have three phases. The perception is this capturing of information from speech and from camera, which analyze everything. And then we can make face recognition, gesture recognition, speech recognition, and so on. And in the central brain of the robot, there is a memory and also an emotional model. So in this case, the robot can understand the situation, how the person feels, how she is, and in the brain take a decision and go to make an action that means behave in the according way. I mean, if somebody is sad, behaving sad, if somebody is happy, behaving accordingly. So this is a quite complex platform. I show you just a more diagram of it. Yeah, of course, more detail can be found on internet. And now we reach already almost the future. What are we working on all the planet, the roboticians who work on social robots? Today, if I would be Nadine on stage, I'm unable to be aware that I am in this room and there are many people looking or listening to me. No robot is able to be aware of that. So a big research is to make the robot aware more than to recognize only one person and dialogue with one person. So this is quite a lot of work that a robot understand which objects is around, which situation is going on, who is talking, when the robot can talk, and so on and so on. I mean, there is maybe more work to do on this aspect than what has been done so far. So I just tell you the state of the art of the research, and thousands of researchers are working on different topics. So what I would like to show you now, in fact, is two examples of Nadine, because we speak a lot of robots and application, but as I said, where are they? So with Nadine, what we try is to bring her to a museum exhibition. I don't know if some of you have seen it, but anyway, it was Future Plus, and it was attended by more than 100,000 people. So what was nice is Nadine was in solo in front of the visitors, and she could interact according to the questions of any visitor. So it was quite a good example because she was autonomous. She couldn't answer perfectly to any question, but at least also with the learning process, she could learn. So I would like to show you this example, and to finish my presentation, I have another example to present.
I feel ready to help anything I can do for you.
I'm happy to see you again.
Hello, Nadia again.
Where are you located?
I'm an art science museum.
Are you a machine?
I am a humanoid social companion. I can chat and remember facts.
Who is my husband?
Your husband is Daniel.
How many daughters do I have?
You have three daughters.
Who is Vanessa?
Vanessa is pregnant.
What is your nationality?
I do not have any nationality. I am a global person.
Do you have feelings?
I am programmed to simulate a full range of human emotions.
What is the weather today?
There will be scattered thunderstorms in downtown Court today with a forecast high of 86 and a low of 78. It's currently 83 and mostly cloudy.
What time is it in Geneva?
The time in Geneva, Switzerland is 4:27 a.m.
What is the capital of Switzerland?
According to Wikipedia, Bern is also the capital of the canton of Bern, the second most populous of Switzerland.
You are a very clever robot.
I am smarter than all the other robots.
You are very sure of yourself.
I am as sure as I can be.
Thank you for the conversation.
It's been a pleasure to be in your company.
Bye-bye then.
See you later, my friend. Looking forward to seeing you again soon.
She was a... Okay, just to finish this presentation, I'd like to show you Nadine has been working 6 months as customer agent at AIA Insurance. And this is very interesting because we speak always of robots, but where do they work? So here, what I'd like to show you is that, you know, she was in the branch Singapore and then of AIA and then in Tempiness. And what she has to do is people take a ticket and people were coming to her and she was able to change addresses to do quite a lot of basic tasks. And the other agent found this very useful because they don't like to do this boring task and they appreciate having Nadine there. So there are more and more demands from banks and insurance to have this kind of robot. I just show you the final video where Nadine works at AIA in Singapore. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you very much, Professor Nadia.